Greetings and welcome to episode 3 of my Napoleon Total War 3 Austro-Hungarian campaign. And this, my friends, how we left it last time, where we were faced, my friends, once again by the French moving in to take the mines in Innsbruck. They really want to strangle us here at Innsbruck, try and strangle our economy here. And to be honest with you, Innsbruck is the weak link here. It is the link, the Munich with the rest of the sort of Austrian-Hungarian Empire to the other side of the mountains here, and the French are always going to be probing here, always. But as you can see, if we auto-resolve, I can pretty much guarantee you that we probably lose this battle because of these forces here. These are experienced, even though they're battalion, they're conscripts, is still very, very effective here, this line infantry. And they've also got cavalry here, like cavalry, but still some good units they got here compared to ours. We've got militia. We've got some skirmishers, a lot of skirmishers, but look at that Jaeger. Look at that, that's a beautiful sight right there. The range is 100. We've also got line infantry, fusiliers. We've also got another line infantry, 47th Czech Regiment. We've also got 12 pounders, so we're actually going to fight this one ourselves because I don't want to lose this mine. I want to take this mine back and bring that sort of economical advantage back to us here, my friends. So we're going to take that. We're going to take this fight straight off the bat here. We're not going to lose this at all. We may lose it to superior forces eventually, but that is the way things go. That is sometimes you just got to take those hits. But we're not going to be pushed around here if we can help it. I'm going to take your advice as well. You said move the sort of the one army I've got, which is quite damaged, into a city. That would help it improve its replenishment rate much, much quicker. I shall do that. I've also got a little plan here, because remember, Napoleon has made an entrance onto the battlefield here. We are up against one of the finest commanders the world has ever seen, if not the finest military commander the world has ever known. So we have to make sure we try everything we can here to hold what we've got here. Now let's have a quick look. Again, the deployment isn't brilliant for us, but we do have this slope here, which we're going to make use of immediately. And we're also going to be sending men out to confront the French army. We are not going to cower, my friends, at all behind the lines here. Right, set up.
Yes, sir.
The cannon we do have here, a number. Any clashes here at all? No, not at all. Right, we are going to send out these onto this flank here.
Yes, sir.
I'm just going to leave these in position for the moment.
Yes, sir.
Slightly over here. We're going to let the artillery have full range here. We may, and also this is our sort of our general units. We've got to be careful we don't lose it. We've got to try and crush this French army as quickly as we possibly can. My friends, let's begin this battle immediately. Where are they? There they are, right there. So, as many of you said, walk your troops, Mallet. Do not overtax them at all. So we're going to walk them. And here as well, we're going to come in from two different flanks here. We know where this enemy... Look at that there. And the range we've got with these as well should prove formidable. What a beautiful looking battalion. And as you can see, we're moving now again. Try and flank these fiends. Speed things up here. There's no point in just waiting here. But then, look at that. The firing here is appalling. This hill is the line of sight here. But that's the furthest we got here. We've got to be careful what we're doing. We don't want to get hit by our own troops here. So actually, we'll pull these to this side here. And these will actually be moved around to here. Otherwise, we're going to blow ourselves to pieces here. Gentlemen. Giving them a is a beautiful shot at last by our cannons. With double timing here, we've got to catch these. Turn around, gentlemen, if you would. Oh, look at that, they've been sent packing here. Broken. With that, we move ourselves thus into position. I've got much better range on them. Freedom of Innsbruck once again, freed here. Now we can repair this mine now, bring it back into the economical hub here. I really have lost 44 men, they lost 199, that's all they've got. If you send troops here, France, you will pay dearly.
Right.
Now there is a little bit of, sometimes you get a little bit of sound problems here, so a few sound issues. Excuse me for that, my friends, but that's out of my control. We're going to remove these here once more, don't want these loitering about. As you can hear in the background, some of the sounds of an engine, so I'm going to move away from here to get rid of it. Sometimes you get a little bit of few issues. I'm going to move these gentlemen into here. So as soon as they get a chance, they're going to be replenished. Okay. Indeed. Oh, look at these fusiliers here. Very nice indeed. And heavy cavalry as well. They're going to be moved into there. Then we're going to move ourselves into here. Napoleon, my friends. Napoleon is here. Now, he will be picking up troops, I can guarantee, and he's going to head for Munich. Munich is absolutely number one target here for Napoleon. I need to be able to trap... Some Russians there. Could be good help to us there, indeed. That's definitely what we need. But what I need to do is I want to... It's going to sound quite a bizarre plan here, but it's what I need to do. I want to be able to sort of engage Napoleon before he besieges Munich. And the reason I want to do that is twofold. The first one is it's going to give me much better for me to be able to defend against him. That means he's got to come to us. We can set our lines, we can set ourselves properly in the defensive position, which we can hold Munich from. Secondly, it's going to give us a lot more time to get troops together to be able to hold and to bring in reinforcements. So what I might do is use militia and set them around Munich, set militia units around Munich, so they almost force Napoleon to engage that unit to get to Munich. So in other words, he's got to attack the militia unit to get there, so that he triggers a defensive mechanism, a defensive trap, should I say. We have to hold Munich against the French. It is a critical section of our defensive line now. But hopefully, Moscow, Russia is going to come and help us now. As you can see, they're sending some quite nice units here, grenadiers. We've got some good heavy cavalry here as well coming to our defence. Hopefully they're going to be sending it to Munich. Hopefully they'll hold Munich. That would be an absolute boon for us. Move these gentlemen back in again, but indeed we can. So again, we can't, and they're going to build up an absolutely staggeringly huge force here in Italy. I can absolutely guarantee it. That's why we've got to get ourselves a decent defensive force here for Venice. We did sally out and we did hit the French that were sort of in Milan to give the French a bit of a kick in and say to them, you're not going to be coming here and just riding roughshod over us. We're not going to allow you to do what you want. Not a chance. As you can see, the Italians, wow. Just wow. They've got an absolutely staggering army here. Remember, these are the proxies of France. Napoleon's proxies is Milan, is Italy. They're big friends, and I'm hoping that eventually the Russians will come and aid us, but whether they will or not, I don't know. What's our economy looking like here? 1661. Not too bad, but not brilliant either. Treasury is pretty good, actually, considering. By damn, we've got some problems here in some of these regions, we really have. So we're going to have to try and hold on to some of these regions here. Yeah, as you can see, people in government is not happy. Industrialization is going to come down. We have to move these units. Look at that, grenadiers. We can't keep these in here. Especially veteran fusiliers. We just can't keep them in here. They've got to be sent to the front line. What we are going to do is we're going to recruit militia units here. I don't know why we keep getting that sound. It's a glitch. It is a sound glitch, unfortunately, my friends. And all I can do about it. Please try and bear with me while I try and get it sorted, but there's absolutely no guarantees. Oh, look at that. Mind you, their morale is absolutely rubbish. So is their range and accuracy. I need more than that, really. I need better troops. What's this general here? Now, why have I got him in there instead of him? We're going to move this gentleman out here. He's going to move to there. Going to move him into there. He's going to give us much better stability, much better control of our army here. We might even get a faster, slow replenishment rate. Almost ready, almost ready. Some ways off here. Let's move him behind here, and we're going to set this militia unit here, across this bridge here. Now that, if Napoleon comes that way, it should trigger off that defensive battle we need. Are they within range of each other? Yes, they are. Will this support? I'm not sure if it will, but that will support. Now, we have got a few problems in our back areas here, but not a lot we can really do about it at the moment. We've got to try and build maybe some courts of justice or bring repression as well and happiness to all classes as well. We'd have to do that a bit at a time. Can we get any more trade, any more? That's just Confederation, they don't like us at all. Oldenburg is friendly. Hopefully we get those ports open, we can do some more. Right, I'm going to move them into the city. Now they are. Yeah, they are in the city now, which is good, so they're going to. They can replenish hopefully quicker. We're not going to build anything here yet at all, because all they're going to do is going to raid it. That's not going to do us any good. These gentlemen will replenish. We've got these here. Heavy cavalry, which will definitely be needed. we've also got these gentlemen moving in. Out of the base. And we've also got this here as well. We're building up a small force here. Oh my word. What happens if we take these out of the city here? It's still fine. So we're actually going to send these down to here to join. We're going to put ourselves in quite a capable army here. Research, we've almost got Army Corps Organization, which was one of our sort of missions set by the High Command. I think we should do okay if Napoleon comes across here. And maybe, just maybe, we can do something about this. But really, I need to engage him outside the city. And to be honest, we do probably better if we have these grenadiers inside the main army here. Right, let's end the turn with the soldiers here. Ah, you see, look at this, there he is, and now he's starting to move around behind us here. The Kingdom of Great Britain, come on Britain, do something to help us here. We need you to send troops across the channel to aid and abet us. Now, Prussia, well, I tell you what, Russia has sent one almost full stack army to help us here, useless. Considering the context of the war we're engaged in, that is useless for us. It really is not good. They may send the force closer to Munich to help us defend against an attack by Napoleon, but honestly, that's not going to do us much good. Now, I take it back, my friends. But only for this one time here. Oh, look at that. That's a beautiful fleet. Come on, Russia. Send your forces hither. Sweden. Hessen. Hopefully when my ports are fully developed, we can indeed bring about some more trade. And Spain. I think Britain could be in trouble here in Gibraltar. I've just got that feeling in my bones. Now look at that, what a force he's... Oh my Gordon Bennett, look at that. What a force. Uh-oh. The Invincibles. One of the best French line regiments of the Napoleonic Wars. We could be in some serious trouble here. Oh my gosh, these are exceptional troops. They really are exceptional. Jeepers, creepers, great balls of fire. Actually, I'm going to try and build another army up here. He's gonna move up to here and join in. Move into here. We're gonna try and get another army in Prague going here, but he's moved. He's basically outflanked us.
Yes, sir.
Can we make him
Reiter!
Engage us here before we're ready? Before he's ready to engage us, probably. I'll put a reserve battalion here. Dutch troops here. Now, he may just go for Innsbruck, in which case we'll allow him to besiege it, and then we will hold him in there by moving this army out, but look what they've got here. This is absolutely... Can we injure? Oh god, this is going to be close. If we assassinate Ney, would that do us... Could we sabotage army? Oh, that's no. Be better. We've got a much better than one of the generals. If we could do that, that would be phenomenal. Look at we've got suddenly a huge boost here. Now again, we've got to keep our economy going at great supply warehouse. We'll just get that nice and close there to the front lines here. Let's get this secondary sort of army here in position.
Truppen! Vorwärts! Ihr ergebenster Diener.
That's pretty good. That's not bad at all.
Bereit machen!
Vorwärts! Get this gentleman moving vorwärts along the roads here. Not bad, not bad. We wouldn't mind, really wouldn't mind. Two militia units here, so that means I can take this line infantry out. And it can go to here to join. Because I think we might have be faced with quite the coalition against us here, with the Italians and the French coalescing here in northern. Oh my god, and Ben, look at that, that's huge. This is gonna be a one heck of a fight. Mind you, he still hasn't recovered from this yet. He still hasn't recovered from that thrashing we gave him. Excellent. I think I'm going to invest here. In some of these here. We can't really get anything else. Let's try if we get basic roads here. Got basic roads. We can get some we can get some militia. Oh, look at those there, not too bad at all. Diplomatic, can we get any more? Now we can get some trade. Excellent, excellent. So what we could do is invest in our trade. Can we? A little bit too much here, trading company 1,200. Possibly be able to open that up eventually. We should be able to hold this region here. This is going to be our main port, our main hub here, so we have to hold Venice. And we've got to hold it no matter what happens. I'm trying to bait Napoleon into an attack here. Well, we've got all of these forces available to us. We can kill or defeat Napoleon. It would be a huge boon to us. It really would. Let's get some more militia for these back areas, as it were. Can we get any alliances? No, okay. Oh gosh, they don't like us at all there, do they? We've got allied with Britain. So that's going to bring us... We're at war with the Batavian Republic, which is basically the Netherlands here. But the British have got these under firm control here. But Britain needs to send some forces here for us, to help us out here, to take the strain off the front we're on and move the attacks into sort of the heartlands here. But look at this, they're getting here. They are doing mightily fine here in terms of what they're able to build. We, on the other hand, are not. Prague can now recruit much better units here. Look at the difference here between those troops and the normal troops. Our troops do not, repeat, my friends, match the French troops at all. This is why we have to try and engage and get Napoleon into the battle. Right, let's end the turn. We can't talk about it anymore. Let's get on with it. Troops are being poured into these areas here. Look at the troops they're sending in here. We've got to hold our nerve. Patience is key here. Come on now, Britain, you have to do something here. Russia, what will Russia do? Will Russia actually do something of note? Will it be a worthy ally, or will it be an absolute dud? Basically, one that just looks after itself, becomes sort of almost introverted into itself, and isolationist, just lets everybody else do all the fighting. Come on, Russia. Send those troops down here. Get them into the war. Don't go backwards, go forwards. Sweden. Hessen. Portugal. Oh, don't do it. Even Switzerland is coming to do something, which is the problem, is the almost the ultimate insult. This is why we're trying to build up our forces where we can here. Britain. Britain could lose Gibraltar. I just got that feeling in my bones. Oh, blimey, there it is. There it is. You're not blocked at all. You just remain where you are. Wait for reinforcements. Oh my god, Bennett, look at the cheapest creep. Look at the cost of these. Mind you, they're phenomenal. Phenomenal generals. Okay, that's fine. Let's bring that up. Now, where are you going, Napoleon? Or where are you going, indeed, sir?
Zu euren Diensten.
Can we assassinate? I'll Ney blew it out, so Ney's gone somewhere else. Oh my gosh, we've done it. We have actually done it. We've killed, or we've injured at least Napoleon. Oh my word, that is unbelievable. He's dead. He's dead. We've killed Napoleon. Oh my word. What a blow to the French that must be. We've surrounded this now. Can we move this gentleman into here? That must be Michael Ney there. There has to be Ney. Can't move over there, but we've done a sterling job. Oh my word, if we could sabotage his army as well, it would be wonderful for us. Look at these veterans here. My word. One of the most notable infantry regiments of the Napoleonic Wars, the 19th. Oh my gosh. The troops that he has got at his disposal scare me. But we're not going to remain sort of cowering behind anything here. No, my friends, that is not what we do whatsoever. That is not what we do. What we do is we build and we construct and we do what we need to do here to hold what we've got. Look at that. Come on, gentlemen, for goodness sake, get yourselves repaired here. Put 1,000 into there. Let's get our economy up and running at least. And oh, that's going to drain us quite a bit here. Alright, let's get some of these. Let's get some of these distant sort of rear. Rear areas up and running here a bit as well. We've got not too brilliant here either, is there? So I think we'll have another militia unit here. Tax burden, eh? I'm afraid we've got to pay for the war. The war is not going to be paid for by itself. Now, come on, Russia. Send these troops here down to help us. We need your help. I never, ever beg for anything, ever. And I'm not begging now, but I'm just asking you to just send some troops down here. Just to aid us here. We've got a perfect opportunity. We've killed or assassinated Napoleon. He could be dead. He could be dead for good. In which case, the French have just taken a massive, massive shock there to their system. That spy there, this Ferdinand Becker, look at that. Has just earned his spurs. He's earned his stripes 1,000-fold. And this army's back up and running already. Fantastic. Now, if we could even throw this army either way into the battles here, but he's obviously going to move in for us here. We will engage the French if they come this way. Please stay there, Russia. Please keep your armies here. Munich is going to be so important to this battle. The whole hub here. If they take Munich, they will effectively cut us off here and put almost an even bend here on this front. The front will no longer be straight. It'll have sort of a massive French position here all the way down to here. And we will then have to launch attacks from Prague. It's not going to be good for us. Fully ready, fully operational. Look at this one here, almost ready here with this light cavalry. Can we do it, my friends? Can we do it? Let's end the day here. Let's see what's going on. Oh, they're withdrawing. Wait a minute, did you see France? Whoa, look at Paris. Come on, Britain. Britain has to do something here of note. It has to try and draw French troops away from the sort of eastern front, as it were. My word, they're combining into quite the potent force here. Jeepers creepers. There it is. What? Oh my word. We'll let them take that there. We're not going to engage that force there whatsoever. Where exactly are you going, my friend? Where exactly are you going? Oh, could we actually see some movement here? No. Got no idea what Russia's doing here. Not a clue. If they were to send forces down, they could change the whole... you know, the whole scope, the whole way this war is fought could be absolutely put on a completely different tilt here. We would effectively, you know, ramshackle the French with these Russian armies. Ooh. Size the Italian armies there. That is genuinely scary. Nothing silly from you Ottomans. Nothing silly at all, please. And Spain has also occupied Gibraltar from the British. Okay, the bows and mines. We are not going to engage this force here. It is scary. Oh, look at that. Adolf Holzer. Again. Yes, spy network established. Fantastic. Plus one subterfuge. Brilliant. Galicia. Basic royalty coming in. 1333. Not too bad at all, but not brilliant either. So to invest this quite wisely here, can't advise invest it in that. None of this would be good enough. We might hold it back actually. That,
sir, I have a feeling.
So close to being ready here, but they're taking so long. Now where are you going exactly? Will they move up to here? If they do, we'll have to break out of Munich here. Move this army,
sir,
in. And all of these in to try and defend it, but we'll be pushed. Stuttgart is not. Ah, the spy has stayed here. Can we sabotage the army? Sabotage that army. This time.
Yes, sir. March.
We can't. France hates us with a passion. Spain does as well. Can't get anything yet. You would have to try and get. Whoa. Make an alliance with you. Nope, they're not interested whatsoever. That's fine. Got a quick turnaround here. 133, so I should answer that. That's going to try and build up a little bit of a bank here. What I wouldn't give to be able to get Milan. I love the amount of Milan, but that's good. Look at this. Look what they're doing here. They are just going to absolutely outproduce us here. All because of the backing of the French. National Guard is much armed with muskets. They're not brilliant. So they don't have brilliant troops here. Still, let's end the turn. Let's see what these are. Phenomenal troops in here, though. Let's end the turn. We do have now Russian assistance in Innsbruck. Oh my god, look at the size of that army there. Outside Stuttgart. There it is. Okay, okay, what we're going to do is we're going to decline that attack there. There it is. There it is, my friends. There it is. The battle we've been seeking. This is the battle we've wanted. This is the battle that we've wanted here. But we haven't got these in to help us here at all. They're too far away. Drats. But still, if we can get these onto the battlefield before these come along, we will be in good strength here to do something. But they've got some phenomenal units. But if only these joined in, mind you, they will probably come next time and be able to hold here. Right, we're going to take this fight. We're going to take this fight right now. If only we'd have gotten that other one behind us into the battle, but then again, we might need it later on in the fight here. We've got Louis, Alexandre, Despreau, we've got Franz, Steinheim, Ferdinand von Österreich, Este, or Esther, and Michael Rabe. I do apologize for both my French and my German accents here. My German pronunciation, should I say. Horrendous, my friends, I know that. Absolutely appalling. I do apologise, I really do, but this battle is crucial here to what we can do here. Putting that militia unit there, just there, has really done us a lot of good here. We can hopefully reinforce this, whatever happens here. So, we need to pull back. We need to pull back here. We cannot, under any circumstances, keep these. Where's the demarcation line here? We can't keep these gentlemen here at all. They're going to fall right back here.
Yes, sir.
And we're going to begin the battle. Thank goodness. There's the French there. Where's a good place for us to deploy here immediately? Probably on this hill here. Actually, what we're going to do is we're going to set ourselves here. Oh, ho, 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 ho. What a beautiful sight. Look at this. It's magnificent. But again, proper deployment is crucial here. Cool, calm head here, my friends, is vital to us holding victory here. Or achieving victory, should I say. Blimey, Charlie. Blimey, Charlie. If these gentlemen here can hold even for a brief moment.
Our general is under attack.
Of course he's under attack. Oh my word, what a beautiful sight.
battalion. Yep.
Protect this flank, gentlemen. Protect this flank. Hold, lads, hold. If these horse guards attack them, they will be absolutely butchered. Already we're engaged here with a heavy horse, dragoons. Come on, gentlemen, move. Move yourselves immediately into position here. Quite old, you know, old lads. Look at that, what a sterling defence there. A sterling defence. Where are those French guns? They're pulling back here. You've got to come to us. You've got to come to us. Gentlemen, move. We can rest later on. Move. And limber. Good grief. Hold, lads, hold! Look at these anchoring here. God, what the heck are you doing? Hold, lads, hold. You can put the door on me, just hold it. It might not be brilliant. Excuse me, look at the back of my face. That is one screen. Oh, that attention. Whoa, 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 where have you come from? still running. Oh my god. Got to close the door.
Running, sir!
Don't go running, look where they are!
Running, sir!
Of course they're running. Look what they're doing.
Fatigued, sir, and must rest.
Thank you.
Your men are running, sir.
Of course they're running. Where the hell are you doing?
Men are fatigued, sir, and must rest a while.
What a fight!
Nemo!
That was
Niemand wird uns besiegen.
They got 459 men left. We've got 2,306. Oh my gosh, we've almost completely wiped them out. Look at that. Look at this. Look at this regiment here, the Kaiser Franz II Regiment. Beautiful. Look at that. 306 kills. Oh my gosh, that is, what a fabulous fight that was for us. Come on now, Britain, you have to respond in kind. Oh, that was wonderful. Looks like Cardiff is being used as quite a... Yeah, that's it. That's it. Well done, Britain. Some bold moves. That was fantastic. What a fight that was. What a fight. Whew. Keeping that one battalion on that bridge has saved our bacon. Look at Vilnius, it is packed to the rafters. Send those troops forward. Are they going to send them to join the war? Will they send them to join the war? Come on now, Russia. Do something useful here. Obviously you're not going to, it's fair enough. Sorry, Italy. You just keep loitering around there. Portugal, Bavaria, Ottomans, and finally Spain. Oh, there it is. Look at that. We've got our money for that. Thank you very much. We gained general. Excellent. And Eastern Mystic. Yeah, minus one prestige. Not very good, is it? Just as the peace was meant, just this. Oh dear. It's not going to help, is it? Very much. Right, 1350. Why is our trade? And we do have high army keeps. So. Can we? No, we can't. So. And we do have a nice bank here now. So I'm probably going to upgrade these here. And this one here as well. That's a pretty powerful force there, even if we can't, don't admit it. But look at that. They've taken an absolute thrashing here.
We are not shift.
Can we indeed assassin? Oh my god, Napoleon's back! You just can't keep this guy down, can you, at all? But my word, this is... Oh, Gordon Bennett, we've taken some beating here. We're going to take a while for us to recuperate here. I'm going to move this gentleman a little bit closer in here. Just, we've got absolute full reinforcement here.
Okay. Eure Befehle, Majestät. Linke Seite, Marsch.
Right, he can recuperate as well. He can stay as he is, but these will hopefully... Oh, actually, Court of Appeal. Oh, Military Academy, I'd love to get Military Academy. Don't become available for a moderate rate. Yeah. Oh, Bavarian Light Infantry. Oh, not bad at all, not bad at all. But we can't afford it just yet. We have to keep our, you know, what we got here. We're going to try and build another army here. Of justice in there. This is the front line now. This is the front line, but look at that. Look at the absolute battering we gave. But we handed out pretty much. We have destroyed an elite French army here. But there's Napoleon. Can we stop him again? Garde Nationale. Sapeurs. Whew, it's not a full stack army. And neither is here in Stuttgart, so we might just be able to get a chance here to fight. Instant guard eventually. Look at that Wittenberg. Wow. But if we can at least wound Napoleon, that would be a huge boost to our campaign there. But again, these are still replenishing here. can recruit still here, but I think we've got a pretty powerful force here just to ward off these. They're still replenishing here, but still, actually they're not that good, these, they're not brilliant, they're pretty much militia units. Mind you, they're grenadiers, they're pretty good. But we have stood up to the French here very well here, my friends. Anyway, I'm going to end this episode here, my friends, with that Battle of Munich, which really did put a huge dent there in the French. Hopefully the British will come forth with an army and cross over and try and do some damage to the French. That would be fantastic if they could. But anyway, friends, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, please comment, like, and subscribe. And as always, my friends, please keep your comments coming down below. Please let me know what I think I should do. I'm going to try and build up our economy a bit more now, get things rolling in that department, and also hopefully get Munich up and running, hopefully try and delay Napoleon as long as we possibly can there in Stuttgart, even if we can kill him or even sabotage the army. That's what we're going to try and do. But until next time, my friends, bye for now.